Hey guys, here we are. Back on Windchaser, our beef farm. We're just down here kind of making. Playing with our telehandler here. Some mixed rations. We just finished planting and collecting our bales. We planted over a whole wheat field. Since we don't really have much to do, we're just kind of over here making some food, trying to get rid of some of our bales. It was over 500 bales that came out of both fields. Had to make quite a few changes over on this farm since I started playing on it. Anywhere from like floating buildings to floating cows to missing triggers to poor layout to bale shed. We put in our bale shed here. Need to fix some more fill planes, but I notice one thing is that the collisions on these bales when you have them so close together really like legs the game when you back something into it, like a bale fork or a trailer. It really starts to lay the game. Not sure why it does that. It did that since day one, so. Sugar beet. And this is all the crops from our grain farm that we planted. So it's basically the same thing as a dairy farm, but you just have more things you need to feed your beef in order for them to grow. And you only get money when you bring them to the slaughterhouse, so. Anyways, today was my last day of classes for the year, which means we had about 2.5 weeks of vacation until our third year starts up, so feels nice to be done. Had my white coat ceremony on Saturday. Parents and sister flew up, or flew over here from Wisconsin, so nice to see them. And they took the Amtrak trains down to New York, and they're going to come back up and visit some more after that. So we're using a lot of New Holland on this farm. One of these T8s is rented, as is that planter. We just rented to help get the bales collected while the other one is, the other tractor was doing other things. I keep forgetting what silage is. We did a little work on this field, just squared it up parallel to the other road. So it's a little bit easier to farm and mow with the GPS. Went and sold a few bales down at the bale cell to see if that was working, and it is. Why does this tell me how much is it? So anytime you put your fork in these bales, they... At that time, it didn't really do it. See how I have legs right here? And all the bales start to rock. I don't get it, but I have a pretty decent amount of bales over here. I need to put lights in that shed at some point. see we have quite a few bales in here. Stacks are 16 each. 1, 2, 3, 4 by 7, well, 6, 4 by 6 essentially. Oh, there's more over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'd say 4 by 7 by 16. I'm pretty sure that's the most bales I've ever collected and stacked. I mean, I used to do it manually and trailer it like you do in real life with a telehandler or a skid loader and bring it back to the farm and unload it. But, you know, that bale stack, after you do about a trailer or two, that bale stacker starts looking mighty nice, so. It's nice to have. It still takes quite a time, quite some time with that. I just drive it back to the farm and stack it in. It would be nice if you could, like on multiplayer, have someone that just brings in bales and stacks all the bales at the corner of the field, and another guy's driving truck with a skid steer or telehandler and loading up the trailer and bringing it back to the farm. You know, if you're baling far away, that's pretty much how you'd have to do it, because you can load up four bales at a time with the telehandler no problem and stack it pretty tight, and it wouldn't take very long to load a trailer. You can load it all from one side, just extend the telescope the boom a little bit. You definitely have more control if you were to manually stack with the telehandler versus just backing the trailer, because it like interferes. And anyways, I have that bale. So, straw isn't really worth much. Hay is. So each stack of two equates to 18,000 liters of mixed rations here. The new telehandler, it's great. Has a new little time feature on the dashboard. It displays the time, the in-game time, and the new forage harvester has an amazing engine sound, amazing starting sound, and amazing backup warning beeping noise. What I don't understand is why the in-game equipment decals, you know, still flicker like this. I don't understand why everything flickers. Definitely need to get a bigger mixing wagon, like a semi trailer or something. Make a big mixing model up something. It's something that can do like four times this capacity. But I still have floating cows, I need to fix those. Currently working on a fast manufacturing pull type sprayer tank. I made that Amazon one washable, but I mean, I really wanted an American sprayer, something non John Deere case. So I think fast manufacturing is the way to go. A 120-foot boom. The hard part is, I can model the frame and the poly tank pretty easily, but the boom's a little bit challenging just because it's hard to get exploded view diagrams and, you know, if those aren't available, pictures that are really, you know, show you how everything folds and unfolds and how it's all hinged together and nice pictures for proportions, how everything is sized. And then just finding the time and energy to do it. Gotta love that view. So I probably put at least 10 trailers in this bunker, so it'd be about 180,000 liters. Water love is good.